Welcome back. Check it out. We're playing 2064 read-only memories. Last session was quite an eventful session. If you missed it, go back and check it out in the videos on demand or in the video history. We're going to be picking up today at chapter 3. I did watch enough of my last session to realize that I really should have I should have turned up the volume last time I was playing. I've done so for this playthrough, so here we go. Hopefully you can better hear the voices this time around. I have completely forgotten where we left off plot-wise. Does a bouncer know? Here, let's offer the bouncer. Can we shoot the bouncer? Oh, let's do it. You don't need to threaten the bouncer to... Oh, come on. I know I don't need to, but... the human revolution.
I don't care what your political affiliation is. Whatever you're selling, I'm not buying.
Ooh, that's cold. I mean, he's just a bouncer, so he's paid to act as he does.
Is this supposed to impress me?
Do you want me to... Okay. So, yeah... That reminds me, last where we left off, I got this business card and I got this Human Revolution paraphernalia. Yeah, let's check out Golden Gate Park. It's been a while there.
It's getting late, and not many people are out in the park tonight.
This is true.
Anyways, if you think something here can help our investigation, let's take a look around.
Alright. Carousel. Originally built by the Herschel Spillman Company in 1914, this carousel is still one of the outstanding attractions near the children's playground. Oh, come on. You insist. I don't think we have time to ride it, even though it looks fun. Yeah, seriously. Alright. Order from snack stand. Oh, come on. Come on. Let me... Fine. Let's check out the Froyo... Oh, wow. Looks like somebody had something happen here. Yep, it's still broken, for sure. The water pump's still pumping. Could wield complete power over free refreshments. Yeah, what happened to this? Some older kids got their artistic expression out on the poor police rom. This is a really nice soundtrack. A chalk doodle of the police rom that some kids drew. A chalk doodle of the police rom. Oh, okay. It took me a while to parse this. So it's not that the police made a ROM, it's that the ROM is a police ROM, and this is a chalk doodle of the ROM that is the police ROM, and this was drawn by some kids. It's not that some kids drew the police ROM, it's not that the police made a ROM, it's that there is a police ROM, of which there is a chalk doodle that was drawn by children. Okay. Hope you followed that, because I sure didn't. Yeah, right. I can't attack the police, Rob. Alright, let's check out the art studio. It's closed in 1974. Reopened in 1984. Wow. Dude, that's been open for like 80 years. Let's tamper with the art. Yeah. Okay, fine. We'll bug Alfie. How's Alfie doing? You hope it doesn't run out. ROMs do weird things when they can't follow the... Oh. That's funny.
do you mean, like most ROMs?
Oh. Yeah, I guess, you're just saying that most ROMs don't have much nuance. I don't know. I don't know, Alfie.
Did you know that I'll soon have
sparkling water
available?
Sparkling water.
It's just as cool and refreshing.
Sweet. Okay. Tree.
Eucalyptus globulus, the Tasmanian blue gum.
Wow. Did you look that up on the internet?
Trees. The clean lines of the leaves and mottled patterns of the bark are interesting.
Huh. What? What's with you and being artistic all of a sudden?
Quite fun to paint, and it's a rather useful tree too.
Fun to paint. What is with you, Turing?
The oil in its leaves can be used as a medical antiseptic or analgesic, boiled into tea, or used as flavoring in foods.
That sounds familiar for some strange reason. I can't pinpoint. But that is a pretty special tree.
Even used as a fragrance for soaps.
Sweet.
Many of the trees in this park are excellent specimens of the species. It's one of the only topics I've permanently committed to my personal memory.
That, along with my diet. So, yeah, how do I want to grill him this time? I don't care about his memory. Let's ask him about art.
I do. However, I originally started by painting landscapes. My interest in the arts began through Bob Ross's work, and he focused on landscapes.
Huh. I wonder if that provides any motivation by the actual artist of this game. I'm curious. I mean, this particular scene, you could see the sky fade from blue to pink, or magenta. You see the orange pipe in the bottom of the screen contrast with the gray sidewalk. You see the carousels and, I don't know, some kind of purplish color, and obviously the trees are green. And then in the background you got this yellow house with a gray roof and the red, amber, orange tint to that. I meant to say brown, but you get the idea. Just, this seems like something that Bob Ross could paint. Really, I'm not the greatest painter ever, so what do I know? But I wonder if this particular scene, though, was in some way motivated by that style.
It wasn't until recently that I moved on to other forms of composition.
Like decomposition? No. You know, I'm just going to keep asking him questions.
Yes, have you heard of him?
Really? You're going to answer my question with a question?
During my initial stages of mental growth, Hayden limited my media access to mostly only educational programs.
Okay.
I had almost a century of public access television to review, and I stumbled upon Mr. Ross's excellent show, The Joy of Painting.
Inquiry. Are you not capable of doing quadrillions of clock cycles per minute or per second or something? How could it take you a long time to review through a century of public access TV? But anyhow, The Joy of Painting.
He used an easy-to-learn wet-on-wet oil painting technique, and I started to paint along with the episodes. I also find his philosophical views compelling. He often used anecdotal stories from his life to illustrate his opinions.
I'm just gonna let that slide. Because he's a decent person. At least, I don't know him personally, but he seems like a pretty decent person.
I respect the man quite deeply. I've committed all 403 episodes of the series to my personal memory.
Alright, do you have a favorite? have been checkmated by this line of inquiry. If I'm going to keep assaulting him with questions, I do have to show some curiosity about Turing himself.
Ah, yes.
Or itself.
I don't actually store most information on my local memory. It's actually rather limited, and I have to be a bit choosy about what I keep.
For a ROM who boasts about how flexible he is, how well accomplished he is, you think that he could just like bolt on a hard drive to one of his arms or something and say, hey look, I got all this information just around with me. It seems a lot more convenient and or comforting to have just that extra anchor than to have to reach out to the meshnet. Unless you're confident, I guess, that the meshnet's available when you need it.
So most of the information I utilize, I just pull off the meshnet when needed.
Yeah, no, that... I could rant for an hour about just, like, why putting things up in the cloud or the meshnet or the interwebs just isn't the greatest thing for things that you need. It's great for things that you want. It's not great for things that you need.
It's like relearning things over and over again. I'm sure you would find it tedious, but I enjoy making sure my reference tables are up to date in my spare clock cycles.
Okay.
I mostly store things locally if they are of some critical importance to me, like information pertaining to personal memories or knowledge that would be helpful if I found myself disconnected from the net.
Like I said, things that you need, don't put on the net. Things that you want, sure. But personal memories, really? Really?
Well, as I said, I keep things pertaining to my personal memory.
Okay.
It may seem insignificant, but without the information about Eucalyptus globulus, I lack critical details about my painting history and the local area, both of which I find important to my emotional development.
You know, again, I just have to let it slide.
Sometimes it can be a bit difficult to know what's important and what isn't, but I fear losing parts of myself.
Good for you.
So, Eucalyptus globulus stays. Of course I'm cute. The basic ROM form factor is designed to place us firmly outside of the uncanny valley.
Well, duh.
I can't imagine adoption rates for the technology would have been very high otherwise.
Sure.
Of course. Enough about the happy little trees.
Oh, they're happy trees. You didn't mention that.
You have to excuse me for chattering on like that. We'll have plenty of time to discuss things once we found Hayden.
I've almost made him forget. Anyway. Can we talk to the tree? Aww. Bye-bye, birdie. Alright, can we cut down the tree? Spoiled milk is not very good fertilizer. Let's see. Does the tree want my ID card? The tree probably doesn't care about who you are, but the birds might. Okay, well, we got something going for us there.
Please do not ask me what I'll be stocking Hassie. I'll only contain cool, refreshing water.
Oh, come on. I want Hassie. Well, that was a nice little sojourn through the park. I probably misused that word. So, where do we want to go next? Let's check out the dog patch. Oh, wow. Apparently I remembered correctly that this is a place you want to go.
This is the place Tomcat said we should head to.
Yeah.
Unassuming and quiet. I'll be honest. I don't think I would be in this section of the city without Jess giving us the all clear.
Yeah, you think?
The crime statistics are quite alarming. So let us get done with our errand here and move on to safer ground.
Nah, let's hang out here. I was looking at this last option here. Good to see your self-preservation routines are working overtime. Yeah, no, I'm gonna make him worry. Let's just hope she sticks to her half of the bargain.
I'm sure she will.
I can't make him worry.
Jess is a bit aggressive and standoffish, but I would not accuse her of being dishonest or underhanded.
Well, good for you.
But I guess I did just meet her, and she is a lawyer, an occupation known for slippery thinking.
See, I got him to worry, but it took me a little bit of effort.
Perhaps we should hurry this along.
Hurry what along?
Tomcat is waiting for us to call them when we arrive.
Oh, right. Right. I forgot. Fine. Do I have a phone here? We've got headphones. Let's play some music. That's a nice little track. It's too bad I can't leave that running while I pick out a different item. Is there a phone over here? Access node? Let's...
Parallax Walk, AN-19 Security.
Sup?
Hello?
Yes, can I help you?
I'd like a burger, and a fries, and how about a milkshake? Oh, wait.
You're at the access node on Cesar Chavez in Indiana, right?
Uh-oh.
That's right.
Oh.
Be quick. Don't touch anything. Got it?
I think I resumed from the wrong save file.
This conversation never happened. And you're on your own if you get caught out there.
Yeah, no, I definitely loaded... Definitely loaded the wrong save file.
Let's go inside, and I'll call Tomcat.
Hang on.
This place doesn't look like it's had any maintenance in years.
No, I've got to go find my save file, guys. Saves. Yeah, let's pick up from here. My mistake. Apologize for that digression. That was really fun. It was perhaps one of my favorite moments in the game was exploring the park there. Huh. What an amazingly refreshing 30-second nap. Okay, can we do that again? Oh, come on. Fine. Coffee? Dude, it's all about the tea and the hot chocolate. I don't suppose Lappy works yet. Didn't think so. How's our plant doing? Oh, it's dead. Didn't come back? Alright. Can we encourage it? You're never gonna make it anyway, Wilty. Okay. So, let's pick up the book. Well, okay, let's not. Sup, Turing? It's Turing, your borrowed companion, Rom/investigation buddy. Borrowed.
Can I help you?
Yeah. Can you, like, not look so ticked off? There we go.
Aw, thanks for the hug.
Poke.
Wow, you really like giving hugs.
Poke.
I mean, I do.
Poke. Poke. Poke.
Aw, thanks for the hug.
Apparently I can't annoy him this way either. Would you care for some spoiled milk?
Yuck! I don't have taste buds and this makes me glad I don't.
Oh. Hey. Yeah, like I was saying, if you missed the last session, something happened that's so spoilerific that I'm not even gonna mention it.
I've already read through this. There's nothing here that can help us that isn't already on the meshnet.
So, yeah. feel free to check out that if you... Although you were here last time. But I don't know if you saw the whole thing.
We can now either follow Tomcat's lead to KCOB or Fairlight's lead to Melody's home.
Yeah. Something pretty big happened toward the end of last session. So, let's see. Do I want to go to KCOB or do I want to follow Melody? Yeah, I think I want to try following Melody's lead here.
It depends on what you want our focus to be on in terms of tracking Hayden's trail. Should we follow the media or the tech?
Oh.
Up to you where to go first.
Oh, first? As in, I'm going to have to go both places. Well, okay.
Ready to head out?
Yeah, sure, why not? Let's see. Flower Mansion. Yeah, that looks like a nice place. Wow, don't be so dour. Is something wrong?
What is it?
Wow.
Why do you feel the need to pester me so?
Because you're a ROM, and humans get to pester ROMs?
I'm just thinking. Give me a moment. Sorry. Back on task. Is there anything you'd like to know before we head inside?
I mean, can you tell me about these trees? I suppose not. Alright, sure.
Flower Cybernetics was established in the early 2000s by Melody's mother, Antonella.
Okay.
It started out developing cutting-edge medical tech, including advanced prosthesis and nanoparticle diagnostic and treatment technologies. They were vastly successful when they perfected the first synthetic nerve mesh, allowing direct connection and control between the nervous system and a cybernetic prosthesis.
That's actually really incredible. I wonder when that's going to happen. In terms of just real life, when we'll be able to produce synthetic nerves, and then paralyzed people will be able to use all of their muscles again. That will be fantastic when that does happen.
The majority of their early projects were defense technologies for the American military.
Yeah, the military has quite a budget.
Developing ruggedized military prosthesis for use on injured soldiers, and then eventually electively for special forces.
Predicted around 2024. All right. So, yeah, I'm curious. Yeah, when am I going to get to be able to have, like, I don't know, some kind of super powerful claw or hammer arm thing? Probably not in 2024. Probably, like, 2040 or something. Seeing Turing's responses to things when they hate you catches me off guard. Huh.
This research line culminated in the development of brain-controlled androids as shock troops, long since barred by international law.
Oh, that's no fun.
Melody took over the company from her aging mother, and she fought against developing further military hardware from that point on.
Well, good for Melody. And good for humanity, honestly.
Pushed the company to use the BCA technology for the company's original goals of medical advancement, as well as developing the first direct link virtual reality implants.
Spiffy.
The company is largely successful on a global scale, despite continued legislative movement against extensive cybernetic use, especially brain implants.
You know, these days the big fight over the internet is on net neutrality. And the ability to use the internet in an open fashion to connect to any website that you want, and that any endpoint can be accessible to members of the public so that, you know, anybody can afford internet access and not have to pay extra to be able to get access to high-speed internet. That everybody should have the same right to access to the internet because it's a tool that helps people be productive. In the same way that you'd say that everybody has access to roads and anybody should be able to drive on a road, anybody should be able to use the internet. It's that essential these days. But yeah, that's what net neutrality is kind of about. Obviously, in this timeline here, even by the year 2064, they're still fighting over or legislating over what can the mesh net be used for. Yeah, tell me about Melody.
Not a whole lot.
Okay, that's pretty unusual.
She's largely private, in contrast to her mother's penchant for courting a media circus.
How do you manage to live a private life as somebody in the public eye like that?
Several biographies of former Flower executives show her as intensely passionate about demilitarizing the company to the point of absolute viciousness in the boardroom.
Cool.
But it's been a long time since her days of fighting for the company, and she's since stepped away from the helm. There's talk that she's lost her spine in her old age, but... well, I take that with a grain of salt.
Hmm.
She may have retreated from the corporate battlefield, but you don't change the entire direction of a company as large as Flower if you're a quitter.
Yep.
Stay on your toes.
Didn't Yannick Fairlight say he and Melody had a falling out?
He did, and I can't shine much light on that.
Turing, you're supposed to know everything.
I know that System 1 worked with Flower to help develop the first operating systems for the Direct Link virtual reality implants, so perhaps it happened during that time.
Really, you don't say.
Also, Flower eventually went with a different company for future models of the implant, but there was never any public talk of a personal falling out between the heads of the companies. I'll scrape the mesh for more rumors, but they'll only be that, rumors.
Well, sure.
I can do my best to parse fact from fiction, but it blurs too much for me to be sure what's real.
Also understandable. Alright, here we go.
No time like the present, then.
Alright, but before we do that, let's check out the window. Let's... The anguished cry of the window cleaner bellows in your soul as you smudge one of the panes. Let's smudge the other one. That fingerprint could become incriminating if this trip goes... Wow. Oh, well. Let's see. Okay. The windows try their best to produce deep, meaningful lyrics, but the effort is transparent. Just like the window. Oh. These evergreens are perfectly sculpted. Be careful not to wreck the mold if you touch. Okay. Is there anything else? Can I storm right in the door?
Maybe we should ring the bell first?
Turing, you're such a killjoy.
Being expected is not the same as just barging in, and we're not even expected.
Right, which is why we barge in. What part of this are you not getting?
Maybe we should ring the bell first?
I don't know. Let's see, what else? A brochure for the human revolution? Here we go. Oh. The Organizational Outreach Act of 2043 forbade anyone from presenting pamphlets from groups they weren't affiliated with in private doorways. Let me try to pronounce that again. The Organizational Outreach Act of 2043 forbade anyone from presenting pamphlets from groups they weren't affiliated with in private doorways. That's better. So let's look at the door. It's two dark wooden doors. A small foyer can be seen through the mottled glass. All right, let's look at the doorbell. This looks like the buzzer. Okay, let's talk to the doorbell. Let's put some milk on the doorbell. All right, so, yeah. Ding dong. Wow. That's pretty cool. I don't even want to know.
We meant no disrespect. Your guess is as good as mine.
Well,
mine says we can go in.
I mean, the door is open. Let's ring the doorbell again.
The door's open. No need to ring the bell.
I know there's no need to ring the bell, but what if you want to ring it?
Just go in.
It's a really cheerful bell.
The door's open. No need.
Okay, fine. Let's look at the door. Dude, that bear is magic. Swanky. See, when I think of swanky, I think of something that's not just really well decorated, but very, very well illuminated. With, like, bright flashing lights everywhere. Maybe my interpretation of swanky is different from yours. Yeah.
What?
What?
Usage of colloquialisms.
Okay.
Is swanky too out of date?
No, but its usage is improper in this context.
It's certainly before my time.
There you go.
Oh, Ms. Flores! Excuse us for the intrusion. My name is Turing, and...
Oh, I know who you are.
Huh.
Hey, I can explain. I know you don't like Dr. Fairlight very much, but I assure you there is a situation.
Fairlight?
Really?
I didn't realize Hayden's research had become a charity case. Though I suppose little boy Yannick will throw money at anything that raises his profile on the mesh.
Oh. Oh. Charity case. She thinks that we're trying to, like, I don't know. Promote some sort of charitable thing.
Wait, you know Hayden? Also, we actually only just met Dr. Fairlight yesterday.
Oh, that's too bad. Now Pat won't have to eat you.
Oh, well, that's unfortunate.
What?
Though I'm not sure your gears would have been good for his digestion.
Actually, madam, of gears.
Well, either way, he's on a diet.
Well, no, I think we should really feed Turing to Pat there.
This philosophy is how I lead my life. Sometimes you eat the bear, and sometimes the bear, well, he eats you.
You know, famous words.
Do you understand?
Not really.
I have to admit, I've heard those words before and I still don't understand them. Other than it means sometimes you'll have great fortune, sometimes you won't.
No, I don't have all day to entertain you, Turing, nor your new friend. Not even for Hayden.
You know, I'm pretty sure that's not true.
You don't have time to waste if you're going to find him, either.
Right.
Okay. So... Can we chat? Wait, what's this? Use melody? Yeah, I didn't know what that was about.
If you were one of Fairlight's worker bees, you wouldn't have made it through the door. So why are you here to badger me about poor Hayden?
You have me at a disadvantage, Ms. Flores. You seem far ahead of us on this matter.
Just call me Melody, darling. And of course, but I'll share a secret or two with you.
You sure?
I have so many questions. Do you know what's happened to Hayden?
I wish I didn't. Maybe you don't want to either.
Oh. Well, that's unfortunate.
Please, Melody, any information you might have.
Yeah, so you remember earlier this chapter, Turing was asking me which place do you want to go first? Yeah.
I haven't had access to any of his research notes, and couldn't track down any collaborators he may have been working with.
Basically, this is not going to provide me all the information I want. We're going to have to go to both places, but let's see how much information we can gather.
Perhaps if we know more, we might be able to nail down a solid motive.
Well, I don't know if I can speculate on that beyond the usual corporate infighting. Not that Parallax is known for that, of course.
Of course.
We had been catching up recently, and he mentioned feelings of being watched. He started to worry he had been discussing your development with the wrong people.
Huh.
When he stopped returning my calls, and now that you've shown up with a total stranger, it becomes clear what happened.
Yeah, but still, can you not tell us anything? Can you be of some use to us?
I see. Can you tell us anything else about his disappearance?
Also, I mean, Turing, really? This, you seem startled by this revelation. That's how you say it. You seem startled that, Melody's able to discern so much from this. I mean, in one of those quadrillion clock cycles between the apartment and here, that should have occurred to you that Melody would figure it out. But, okay.
Oh, I'm afraid not, dear. I've been long enough to know what's coincidence and what isn't.
Okay.
We were hoping you might be able to shine some light on my origins.
More like Turing wants to know more about Turing's origins.
Fairlight mentioned that you had worked with Hayden in the past.
I see Hayden didn't neglect curiosity in your personality makeup.
That's for sure.
Well, you and I haven't properly met, but considering how often Hayden badgered me for design schematics of Flower's latest neural implants, I might as well be your aunt.
Sure, let's go with it.
We'll go with that. I wouldn't mind being an aunt, even to a blue-headed robot.
I'm touched, Melody.
Okay.
Well then, I'm willing to answer your questions for now.
You know, we're like 3 or 4 questions in, you still haven't answered anything, but sure. Yeah, now what's your relationship with Fairlight?
Oh, hell, that old bastard and I have been flashing daggers at each other for the better part of 20 years. I contracted out the software development for our first-gen direct-link VR neural implants to System 1. Things were going great, but after the first model sold like gangbusters, Yannick tried to get into bed with me, literally.
Okay.
I turned him down, very politely, I might add, and then, suddenly, all of the cooperation between our companies dried up.
Oh, Yannick.
We've been at it back and forth ever since. I'd be damned careful about trusting him if I were you.
Yeah. He definitely looks like the sort of person who might... No, never mind. Not even gonna
He's
go there.
A snake. And he'll do anything he can to get what he wants.
I mean, he's intelligent, and certainly, I don't know, he has a way with words. I wouldn't say that he'll do anything he can, but he always looks for meaningful partnerships with people, some sort of synergy, because he realizes his own frailty, and he realizes that he can help other people. And the other people can help him, so he looks for that sort of synergy. But yeah, at the same time, you have to be careful not to, I don't know, become an errand person for him, I guess. I don't know.
Still, I suppose if he tried again now, I might not turn him down.
You haven't seen him.
It would be fun to needle him about me still having my own company when he doesn't have his.
Whatever. Yeah, tell us about this.
Indeed. I don't see the connection between your company and Hayden's research into machine sapiens.
Oh, Hayden wasn't researching machine sapiens. At least not primarily.
Well, was he or wasn't he?
Not to diminish the importance of your creation, Turing, but it's best you know the truth. Hayden is mainly interested in developing a way to transfer human consciousness into a machine matrix.
Well, given his position, that's understandable.
You can see why neural implants would obviously be an integral part of that.
Yeah, so I should obviously take this with a grain of salt that neural implants and all that are everything that he was after.
Oh, I didn't realize.
I mean, you could still have an interest in that sort of technology, but I don't know. Let's see, which question is most important to me? You know, I'm not asking about Turing's development, because I don't know. Man, if I had to pick one of these questions, which would I pick? Likely I'll get to ask all of these, but I'm just trying to think, like, which would be most important to me? Yeah, I don't really care too much about Turing.
If you can even call it involvement. It's a small city. And if you're in the tech sector, you are never more than 2 degrees removed from anyone else.
Yeah?
When he started looking into this pet project of his, he came right up to my door and demanded access to the research logs behind our earlier implants.
Okay. I mean, surely he offered something other than you know what.
Cheeky, but it was impactful and disruptive, as they like to say around here.
Sure.
I couldn't care less about Flowers' patents anymore, so I gave him what he wanted, just to see what he would do.
Okay.
I'm frankly more impressed than I expected I would be, but don't tell him.
None of this is... None of this is making sense to me.
What? Oh, that was a compliment, dear.
Okay, fine. We'll ask about how would Turing's development help with digitizing the human mind?
The concept of transferring the human mind into a computer has been an attractive goal for decades.
Decades? How about millennia? How about the ancient Greeks putting up theater explaining about this concept of robots? and these sentient machines. You know, you don't seem educated in history, so I guess I'll let that slide.
Functional immortality is... powerful lure. The brain is an immensely complicated machine, and even though we know the right buttons to push to make pictures show up, we still can't replicate the entire thing as a technological construct.
I feel that you're dodging my questions. I asked about Turing.
Even with the virtual reality implants, we're really just relying on the brain's ability to make sense of nonsensical signals.
Sure.
So Hayden decided the best way to make a machine more like the human brain would be to work in the opposite direction.
Okay, that's plausible.
Instead of mimicking how the human brain worked, he started writing code that mimicked the functioning of the human mind. Think of it like convergent evolution. Two species adapt in similar ways, but on completely different continents.
Sure, why not?
Hayden is a crack programmer when it comes to information collating. It's why Parallax hired him when they did. So he wrote a bunch of self-modifying learning algorithms that were, frankly, baffling and let them loose.
So... you know, I'm curious. I mean, certainly you were a researcher who had great success producing these devices. But, I don't know. For a researcher, you don't seem to understand computers very well.
Poke and prod them here and there to make sure they value the same things humans do. And we eventually end up with you. Turing.
Interesting.
Sure. We'll stick with that modifier.
Hayden never revealed any of this to me.
I imagine he's pretty tight-lipped. You were the first prototype he considered a real success, and he was afraid of contaminating your development before he had a chance to make good observations.
Well, yeah. Hayden wasn't invested in Turing's development, you say?
I didn't say that.
Okay, what did you say again?
Hayden was quite interested in Turing, even if he is just a step to further research. In fact, he was preparing to publish his findings involving Turing. And I know it's going to make one heck of a splash in the scientific community.
Sure.
See, the most impressive part about you, Turing, is that you're surprisingly stock.
I assure you, Melody, my construction involves only the latest and greatest in ROM prototype technology.
Turing, we're going to have a talk about this.
Exactly. You're not off the shelf, but you're still just a souped-up ROM. More or less like every other one out there.
There we go. Yeah. Let's see if we can... That's awesome how that bear is just sitting there. Just throughout this really... Oh, this is gonna get a... this conversation is going to really piss off Turing. The tension's building here. And, you know, this polar bear over there, or whatever it is, just smiling. Occasionally raising up its hand, blinking, you know. I wonder what's this other thing on the sofa there. Maybe I'll never know.
Your personality algorithms are impressive, but they don't require some new space-age technology to work. Hayden is going to propose that human consciousness transference does not require special brain-like hardware architecture, but merely the right software wrapper to interface with the hardware.
Really? Well, I guess you did spend enough time with Hayden to know that.
Much like how you function.
I suppose that is correct. Still, my my personality matrices do take up substantial amounts of my processing power.
Oh, Turing.
Wouldn't custom hardware have capabilities that better serve such a demanding specialized task?
Turing, do you not understand technology at all?
Sure. There's still plenty of reason in trying to make a computer that works just like a human brain. Efficiency is an important part of that.
Sure. It's just difficult.
If we can emulate the human mind in existing technology, it means we can start the immortality now, rather than waiting for hardware to catch up with Hayden's software.
Exactly. It's a lot harder to develop specialized hardware. So if you can do it this way, do it this way.
Frankly, I'm not terribly interested in living forever. But there's more than enough people who are.
Thank you for this, Melody. I understand so little of my origins.
And so little about how technology works and develops and increases and evolves. Really, Turing doesn't understand science at all. But at least he's artistic and he's chatty.
Well, I'm sorry, I don't know more of the specifics. Hayden kept me up to date on his progress, but only in the vaguest of ways. If you can hunt down his notes, I'm sure they'll tell you more.
Of course, we'll keep looking. Now, perhaps we could ask some other questions?
Actually, you know, we kind of owe it to Melody to give her the notes. Just saying, for all the favors that she's done for Hayden.
Sure, sure. Good. I can get back to my retirement.
Thank you for your time, Melody. We'll be in touch later.
Oh, one more piece of information for you, if you'd like it.
Sure, we'll take it.
I've got the contact info for a Vincent Mensa, who I think might be of help to you.
I'm trying to decide if that's a play on words or not. Probably not.
Vincent was working more closely with Hayden inside Parallax, mostly on his company-approved research on data collating algorithms for the mesh.
See, there, now we're talking. There's some real science going on. Data collating across a distributed network is tricky.
I'll send him a message and ask him to meet you somewhere. He owes me a favor anyway, and might be able to give you some more information on anything else Hayden may have been working on.
You seem awfully cooperative. Why?
That would be fantastic, Melody.
Okay, it's definitely a Mensa reference.
Perhaps Golden Gate Park.
Be careful, Turing. I don't like Fairlight's stench all over this scenario. Don't show him too many of your cards.
Cards? This euphemism is unfamiliar to me.
Don't tell him anything if you can. Fairlight is more dangerous the more he's informed.
Oh dear. Oh dear. This makes me worry.
Thank you, Aunt Melody. Wish us luck.
And seriously, I think the game is going to escalate and you'll eventually have to make some decision based on that sort of information. Alright, so we talked with Melody here. Let's see, we got strawberries, we got a teapot. Oh, well, yeah. I'm sorry. Strawberries. Can I take one? They look too good to eat. Fine. Pat. Oh, he's a butler. Wow. Okay. Can we talk with Pat? So, grr and stuff? Oh, that was a bad joke. Pat, what are the burdens you bear? Pat, what is the meaning of life? Oh, come on. You could have given us 42. Woof. Oh, have I confused it? Alright, fine. Room control. Well, yeah. Oh. Oh, wow. I hadn't even thought about that, but that makes sense. What's on the monitor? Media Blitz? Alright. Yeah, fine. A planter. Nice. Got a nice squeaky plastic on furniture sound. Huh. There's a gardening ROM. Just that focuses exclusively on gardening. Probably a shared ROM unless, I don't know. Let's look at the fountain. A huge marble fountain. Adorns the courtyard. Its pleasant bubbling sound can just barely be heard over the TV and outdoor ambience. Oh, that's a cat. The most regal looking robotic. Oh, it's a robot cat. That's lame. Turing, can you talk with the robot? The name on her collar says Lily. Cat, how about some milk? If the cat had the ability to drink from a saucer of soured milk, it would become the single most spoiled entity to ever exist. Checkmate. You got me, game. Alright, let's go back in. Oh. Nothing special. Can we ring the bell again?
Let's just go in.
Oh, okay. No. Seriously, so we're supposed to meet up with Vincent Mensa somewhere. Flower Mansion's where we're at. Oh, Golden Gate Park. Sure. Guy. I don't suppose that guy is the person I'm supposed to meet with. Look at guy. You've never seen this person, and they appear to be waiting for someone. Perhaps this is who you're supposed to meet? Nah, what are the odds? Here we go. Here's some spoiled milk.
Can I help you?
Yeah, I was wondering, can you accept this package from me?
I don't really have time to talk. I'm waiting for someone.
Oh, okay.
Are you Vincent Mensa? We're here for a meeting on behalf of Melody Flores.
Oh, good. You're Melody's people.
There we go. Credentials established.
Do you have everything that I asked for?
Nope.
There must be some miscommunication. Melody said that you would be able to provide us with some information about Aiden Weber's projects within Parallax. He has gone missing, and any information we get may be useful.
Damn that old woman.
What?
We had a deal. She promised me, and I'm not giving up anything until I get what I need.
Wow, you suck.
I already know Hayden is missing.
Okay.
Why else would I be willing to sell corporate secrets to Flower? This was my chance to get out of the city.
Okay.
Instead, she sends the two of you, hat in hand, with nothing.
Yep, classic Melody.
I'm assuming you're Hayden's little pet AI?
Yep.
Insulting, but accurate.
Look, I'm sorry to come off callous. I do want to help.
Yeah, sure you want to help.
Hayden was a colleague and a friend, and I want to know if he's okay. but I also need help getting the hell out of Mio SF. And now, my info is my leverage, and it's not for free.
Okay, I could see that. Fine.
I just have to find another buyer. Maybe after I make another deal, I'll be able to pass it to you.
Perhaps we could assist you? My friend is a terrific journalist. Being skilled at hunting down people and information is part of the job.
Yeah, we're gonna get information for free, guys.
I don't know. Look, I need 100,000 credits, an untraceable car, and a fake passport for me and my wife, Francesca.
Yeah. Yeah, I think we can make this happen, but... man, this is not gonna look good for everybody else that we're working with.
If you can get me all that, I'll give you anything you want. Hayden's research notes, what I know about Parallax, my company's security credentials, whatever.
So, how am I supposed to trust him?
If you're really sure journals can come up with that kind of stuff in one day. Might?
Well, what? I mean, obviously Melody played you, Melody played us.
Dear God, I'm doomed.
Yeah, you are.
Melody only gave us a rough sketch of what you need. The more you can tell us about the situation, the sooner we can fulfill your request.
Turing, you are so full of it.
Sure. As long as it isn't the juicy stuff.
So, what do you do for Parallax?
I'm the head applications engineer for their data analysis division.
An applications engineer? I would have guessed like a systems architect, a network engineer. An application? Well, okay, I guess that makes sense, but it's more than an application, it's an entire system.
Or maybe was, is what I should be saying. If Hayden is the big brain who comes up with the math that runs the search algorithms, I'm the guy who figures out how to collect and apply the data that we get.
Right, but that's not an application, that's more like a systems engineer.
We've worked pretty closely for years, but he's head and shoulders above me as far as theory goes.
Sure.
Hayden built a fully independent machine intelligence in his spare time.
Yeah, he did.
Don't get me wrong, I'm not trying to bash myself here.
Also, try not to bash Turing for saying he's just something that was produced in Hayden's spare time, you know. But
I'm a good software engineer. Probably one of the best.
Sure.
But machine intelligence? In a form factor like yours? Now that blows my mind.
Sure.
We've got full immersion, virtual reality, yet most people would still call you science fiction.
If you say so.
Because Parallax is rotting from the inside out. Hayden going missing is the last straw, and it's a big-ass straw.
Yeah.
There is. How do I put this without giving it away?
Also, you're in California, so.
There's a new project about to roll out, and it's going to change everything about how Parallax does their business worldwide.
That doesn't sound good at all.
Since the launch of the MeshNet, we've had some board shakeups, and the people at the top are different from the ones who previously run the company. The altruism the company displayed in the past is gone. They're harder, more ruthless, and more concerned with profits and power than ever before. Not just richest company in the valley power either. Real power.
You know, unless you're able to convert that wealth into political influence and military influence and such, that sort of richest company in the valley thing is just temporary.
My guess? Parallax got rid of Hayden because he was about to do something that would get in the way of that.
Okay.
If they're willing to get rid of the brightest mind on their payroll, what's to stop them from getting rid of me? There's a half dozen people who could do my job.
Sure. Well, I mean, okay, so ignoring the fact that you volunteered to sell out everything you had, just completely ignoring your character, I don't know. I mean, maybe they distrust you, but if they reward you well enough and they understand your motives, why wouldn't they want to keep you? In terms of business decisions, this really doesn't make any sense, Vincent.
So I'm getting out before I accidentally step on the wrong person's toes and end up at the bottom of the bay.
You know, for somebody who's so bright, yeah, we'll just leave it there. Do you know anything about Hayden's disappearance?
Nothing concrete. I probably wouldn't have noticed anything out of the ordinary.
Great.
I mean, Hayden goes out for a couple days all the time, right? Conferences and guest teaching. He doesn't exactly share his itinerary with me.
Sure.
I tried asking around and no one would say anything. If he had jumped ship, went to a different company, it would be the talk of the week at the water coolers.
Well, obviously.
Instead, dead silence.
Yep.
Thankfully, he allowed me to keep backups of most of his work, simply because I cross-referenced it so much. He didn't like having it all in one place anyway.
See, that last sentence there makes a lot more sense. I mean, well, no, I guess cross-referencing means you're constantly using his work, and so he doesn't want to constantly be providing it. It's more convenient to him for you to have a copy of his work. But also, yeah, I dislike the idea of that he would want to keep it entirely private. How can you possibly be productive if you're not sharing with other people?
Bring me what I asked for, and I'll tell you more.
Great, we'll go get those things for you.
I need to make some calls, and this part ROM is fun. I want to poke at it a bit.
Really? Fine.
If you do manage to get what I need, bring it here today and you'll get anything you want. Forwarding photos and info for the passports to Turing now.
Alrighty.
And I really hope you can do this.
Yeah, we all do.
I'd rather give it to you than some other corporation anyway. See you soon.
I'm not quite sure where to get fake passports or an untraceable car.
Fake passports? Who said anything about fake?
The only shady folks we know are those punks who vandalized Hayden's apartment.
You... No. No, we're not doing that.
I doubt they could point us in the right direction, but a long shot is better than no shot.
Really? You think that cooperating with authorities might not be the better strategy here?
They might agree to help us in repayment for the damage done to the apartment. They seemed remorseful.
You are kidding me. He's talking about 100,000 credits, not just like...
We should check Market Street for them, in case they regularly hang out there.
Not just like a hassy or two, but a whole lot of hassy.
As for the rest, perhaps Dr. Fairlight or Melody could spot us the credits.
Yeah, Dr. Fairlight could... Well, yeah, either of them really could, but they won't.
That certainly is no small amount, but is unlikely to cause much consternation for either of them, assuming they are as dedicated to helping as they claim.
Yeah, no, see, this is how the hero's journey works, is that they tell you these things, and then it just doesn't work the way you hoped.
Melody is assumably home as usual, and Fairlight did let us know he'd be at the hospital.
Sure.
We could ask either of them for assistance.
Yeah, so Melody says be careful about Fairlight. So given that all that Fairlight gave us was a contact for Melody, probably should go back to Melody for help.
Up to you to decide which would be a better course of action.
Obviously Melody, just out of sheer politeness. See, what are all these points here? There's the hospital, Market Street to check out the dudes, and yeah, let's go to Flower Mansion. Ask Melody what the hell.
Hello, Pat. Could we see Melody?
Nope.
We'll see, we'll see. Melody. What the heck?
Turing, I'm not saying I don't like seeing your little pixelated face. You're certainly better company than most of the humans I have to deal with. But I am a busy woman, you know? Lots to do.
Oh, of course, of course.
Like that?
Like, lie to us? And to Vincent?
Traitor.
Now we're talking.
Anyway, maybe we should space these little visits out a good bit further. Familiarity breeds contempt, after all. And I'm very good at contempt.
Good for you.
I apologize, Aunt Melody. You've stated before that you like your peace and quiet, but we need your assistance.
Oh, we're running with the aunt thing, are we?
See, that was actually really well put by Turing. It was for all the times he F's up a conversation that we understand that you wanted some peace and quiet. However, we require your assistance. It's just so polite and formal and respectful.
Another woman would tell you not to butter her up, but oh, flattery will get you everywhere. With me.
Yeah, I don't know about that.
All right. What do you need?
You know, just your whole personality reminds me of Ursula the Sea Witch. Just saying. Yeah, Vincent needs help. And you promised him something.
I can only imagine.
Really?
If he's willing to turn coat on Parallax, I bet he feels like a mouse in a cat farm.
You don't say.
I know they don't actually farm cats, Pat. It was a metaphor.
Oh. Oh, you think they don't farm cats?
Whatever. It was a simile then. I am not going to play semantics with you.
Man, that's one smart bear.
Moving on. Tell me what the trouble is, and I'll try to conjure up a solution.
So... what? What is this? I mean, yeah, I was just hoping there'd be some variety here, so I'd have, like, a choice between ticking her off and not ticking her off, so that I could deliberately choose the option that's more combative, you know? I don't get a choice. And so, yeah, I'm not gonna start from a position of weakness. No. Well, you seem happy.
Adorable. You must think you have quite a bite.
No, not really. Just stating facts, you know. Oh, Pat.
Not as good as Pat's. Or mine, for that matter.
Hey, you wanna get to Fairlight? We can get you to Fairlight.
I've been destroying people my entire life, and I've got a few more years of it yet.
Good for you.
Keep trying, though. Practice makes perfect.
Yes, Mr. Mensa says he needs 100,000 credits before he's willing to speak openly.
Yeah, I suspect this is going nowhere.
He also said that you already promised it to him, and that he won't be able to get out of the city without it. He'll give us the information once we have that, plus a few other things I'm certain we can get on our own.
What? You can't even scrape together that kind of money.
Oh, Melody.
Your friend's not much of a journalist, eh, Turing?
According to the statistics that I have found, it is unlikely that a journalist of any caliber less than the best would have that amount of liquid assets on hand.
Yeah, you think?
The pay for the profession just isn't that high, Aunt Melody.
Well, Turing didn't have to go that far, but you went there anyway.
Oh, I see. I guess it's one of those jobs people do because they get free review merchandise, eh?
Could always sell ninja assassin androids instead.
A spirited return.
There we go. At least Melody's having fun.
I can get you the money, Turing, but only because you're family.
Did not expect that. What is with this game? I cannot predict its plot arc. That's something
just
else.
Give Pat a few minutes to gather it.
Wait, am I being tricked here?
Yeah, just keep moving, you big brute. While we wait, is there anything else you want to grill me over?
Not that you want to know.
Might as well save us both another visit.
Wow. You really don't like seeing us. Maybe Turing has, yeah.
I do. It's a little personal, though. I'd understand if you didn't feel like answering.
Sure.
Just shoot, Turing. I can take it.
Long ago, you lost your mother.
I see that robot cat just stood at attention there.
I was wondering, how did you deal with it? Hayden's only been gone for a few days, and I already feel like my circuits are going to lock up for good.
Oh, Turing, I'm not the right person to ask.
Really?
I hated my mother. She's everything I thought wrong in the world, and when she was gone, I felt nothing but relief that I could start undoing the damage she did.
Okay.
Never mind the fact I had to watch her waste away from the cancer. Death was a blessing for us both. Besides, you'll find Hayden soon. Keep your chin up.
No. Blast it! Enough with this subterfuge!
Yeah. There we go.
We already know Hayden was killed.
There we go.
Oh, no.
I won't be getting him back.
I'm sorry, Turing. I still don't know what to tell you.
There we go. Yeah, so I did warn people at the beginning of the stream that something happened last time.
I've lost people, but never anyone close enough to wound me. I don't know that I've ever had anyone close enough to do that. If you feel like talking about it, I'm willing to listen. Or make Pat do it anyway.
Yeah, at least having this conversation is useful to us.
Thank you. I don't know.
Because now it seems like she's more sympathetic.
Stick it up. Time heals all wounds, or so they say. This too shall pass.
So they say.
Smarter than I give him credit for, that's for sure.
Yeah, how smart is Pat?
It's not the easiest thing in the world to measure, you know?
True.
He doesn't process language in the same way humans do, and even if he can understand me, my translation program just guesses at what he says most of the time.
Okay.
Oh, you have a translator running from your neural implant.
Very perceptive.
Ah, yes. I'm cheating. Though, honestly, even if even without it, I have a pretty good idea of what he means most of the time.
You think?
We've been together for a while now.
Oh.
Considering it only really works on large, typically predatory mammals, we don't have a lot of test subjects.
Wait, you have a cat right there, too. I'm curious, like... did you do something with the cat?
It's a minefield of ethical concerns beyond just being prohibitively expensive. So Pad is a bear apart. At least until we can figure out how to apply the modified neural pathways without frying the brains of 90% of the subjects.
Oh, so how many bears died in your efforts to make Pat understand language?
The tech we developed is good. It just has a damned high mortality rate. Maybe one day there will be a bunch of talking tigers and dolphins building cities in the sea, but for now, we're stuck with creating beasts out of our own species.
Let's see. It seems sad that you're all alone except for a bear, and a cat, and a bowl of strawberries, and some tea, and all the ROMs you have.
Being alone is easier, and Pat isn't such bad company. I mean, what do you want me to do? Cry about never having a husband, a few kids, and a white picket fence? I had a company to run. And my mother's legacy to fix.
I mean, that legacy fixes itself over time.
What's to say some spawn of mine wouldn't do the exact same thing to my flower, just the other way around?
Basically, yeah.
This branch of the Flores line will do well without any more knives being inserted in backs. Thank you very much.
Seems like Melody's got some issues.
Enmity for your mother?
I think that's spelled wrong. That should be like enmity. E-M-N-I-T-Y. Obviously from context it means disdain. It means not liking.
Have you seen what she did to North Korea? It's a wasteland of death and destruction. If we had kept going down the path she charted, the whole world would be like that.
I wonder what's happened between present day out of the game and 2064 in game that North Korea could apply, because that's a pretty hot area.
The information on the mesh does seem to paint a grim picture.
Grim barely scratches the surface. I've been there.
Dare I ask why?
At least under the Kims, it was barely functional. Now, my mother's monsters have ripped every last resemblance of humanity from the land.
Oh. Okay, question answered.
They stalk the night like horrific creatures of legend, keeping the populace in line through constant fear.
You say that like the technology's to blame.
A horror story straight out of the pages of Bram Stoker. That's her legacy.
Yeah, are you gonna beat yourself up over that?
So I can't imagine I'd be a very good mother, just from the example I have to work with. That's life. I don't have any more regrets than anyone else my age does. My legacy will speak for itself, as my mother's did.
Yeah, clearly I can take this all at face value without a grain of salt.
Oh, just in time then. Take the cash and get moving.
Nice.
I can finally get back to whatever it was I was doing before you burst in here.
Thank you, Aunt Melody. Your help has been invaluable to us.
And he does know how to properly use the word invaluable.
Yes, yes. Brown knows later. You've got things to do, too.
Yep. Things, like leaving and, you know, actually doing what the plot says to do.
I feel such a strong resonance with Melody.
Uh-huh.
We're connected by the barest of threads, but she is already important to me.
The barest of threads.
Is that strange?
What about use normal? Wow. Well, you seem upset.
Let's get moving. We still have things to do before we can meet back up with Mr. Mensa.
You don't say. So, let's go to the map. Go get other...
Detective Rivers! To what do we owe the pleasure?
I wanted to check in with you away from the prying eyes of my corporate masters.
Oh, okay.
It wasn't too hard to track you down here. Only took a slight abuse of power to follow your credit transactions in the AutoCAD system.
Oh, Lexi. So when are you planning on actually telling us what you found?
Don't be an ass. Listen, I've hit a dead end on the investigation again, and I could really use another lead from the two of you.
Okay.
I've been busy hunting down a... I'm not sure if I want to call him a soldier of fortune or an assassin for hire.
What?
Either way, I tracked this guy down to see if he might have been hired by Parallax to snatch Hayden, but he's got an ironclad alibi for the relevant period of time. That leaves me with nothing. Not a jack diddly shit. Do the two of you have anything to give me? Otherwise, I'm back to hunting down the froyo-hating robot ghost in the park.
Jeez, that sucks.
At least my superiors would be ecstatic, considering how much they keep riding my ass about it.
Why are you so upset?
We're on thin leads ourselves, Detective Rivers. We have a meeting with someone from inside Parallax who might be able to give us answers. But he's unlikely to want to talk to the police.
Also, like, you remember all that I said about cooperating with authorities? I bet Lexi could do something for us.
I just wish this... Never mind.
Oh, Turing.
Buck up, Turing. I wish this was easier, too. But with detective work, sometimes it's not about being clever. It's just about being more dogged and relentless than whoever you're chasing. You two are my new deputies, right?
There we go.
So keep your nose to the ground and keep digging. I still have a few contacts I can hit up to try finding out a little more.
Wait, can you not help us?
You let me know if there's anything else I need to be going after.
Yeah, we kind of need, like, a fake passport.
Yeah, sure. Just get going. Don't forget, if you die, I'm gonna kick your ass.
Oh, okay. Point taken.
Okay then, we only have a single lead. If Parallax really is as shady as Vincent seems to suspect, it could end up very interesting.
Sweet.
Let's see if we can put an end to this, finally. Oh, I just received an email from Tomcat.
Oh, how about that?
They finished decrypting Hayden's data cache.
Okay.
It seems that it was filled mostly with his personal logs about my creation and mental development.
Oh, wasn't that convenient?
The more technical information was already scraped.
Sure.
Perhaps that is why it was left behind when they snatched him.
Oh. Oh dear.
Still, these files should be enlightening, if only in a personal way. I'll peruse them in my spare time and let you know if I find anything interesting.
I'm sure occasionally you will.
I'd hate for all the trouble we went to be for nothing.
Okay. So, yeah, let's continue with plot advancement. See if we can find these punks. Huh. You seem happy. Sure, why not?
I hope your article is going well.
Why are you out here all alone?
After someone instigated violence at our last demonstration, I make it clear to my organization that their safety comes first.
Yeah. So this is kind of my fault, you know?
Until my people feel safe again, protesting out here is on a volunteer-only basis.
Of course.
It has been a quiet day.
You don't say.
But I will not rest until society sees the error of the path we're going down.
See, this is good. You're seeking to inform and educate people rather than bring a mob around, so good for you. Oh dear. Yeah. What has your group accomplished?
Through some concerted efforts, we've created an alliance with a number of businesses banning service and employment of unhumans.
Okay.
Yeah, they call themselves hybrids, but we call them what they are. I can't respect those who willingly trade their humanity away.
Wow, you suck.
Thanks to our efforts, many local businesses are finally gaining the confidence to only serve human beings. If they wanted to feed animals, well, they'd open up a pound. Why, just the other day, a Neo-SF landlord thanked me for supporting his decision to deny tenancy to unhumans. He already feels better about his decision to seek out our help.
Good for you.
Plus, can you imagine the cleaning fees?
Alright, so try to keep this neutral here. Why is somebody with genetic modifications less human?
I feel it's rather simple. It's even in the name.
Okay, I don't want to ask you to go on, but I have no choice.
Modifying genes means we are changing the very DNA that makes us unique.
You mean that make us unique?
We're getting doctors, among other people with a severe lack of understanding of the human condition, the right to make us into entirely new species.
And this is a problem, why?
We are the byproduct of tens of thousands of years of natural selection and evolution, and now these people want that progress to just be reduced to a formula, to be injected into your skin at your convenience.
I get the sense that you're not a scientist. I also get the sense that, convenience really doesn't seem appropriate at all.
And why? To fulfill some sick fantasy. We have VR dramas. Leave your imagination at home. Besides, why should we give these self-proclaimed animals the same rights as humans when they clearly don't want to be human?
You know? It's just, yeah. Won't shutting down clinics like this cost lives?
That's a leading question. Of course some people have life-threatening afflictions, and it's a good thing that science has evolved to treat all kinds of diseases. Simply wanting cat ears and furry tails does not constitute a disease. A disease of the mind, perhaps.
You do understand that that's not easy work to go through that kind of surgery.
If the government strictly limits genetic alteration surgeries to only life-threatening emergencies, well, that would be a start towards undoing the damage.
The damage, you say?
We are not God. We were made in his image. And his image did not include fur.
How do you know?
That is the greatest misconception of our group.
Yeah, I don't know.
They would have you believe that we'd rather go back to the Dark Ages.
I mean, you totally would.
Oh, sure. The human revolution wants people to go back to washing clothes by hand down by the river, right? We'll all go back to playing with sticks, yes?
I'm taking notes here.
We do not advocate for a reversal of all technology. That would be ludicrous. We merely want severe limitations on genetic enhancements and a focus on medicinal practice beyond gene therapy.
I don't believe this one bit. I mean, if you were... Okay, well, maybe he's accurate in this particular statement, but the fact that he tries to conflate this with safety concerns, and the fact that he tries to conflate this with, like, just basically everything, he's being disingenuous. And he needs to talk with a doctor, talk with people who have gone through this sort of thing, and then try to advocate for what's considered safe practice.
That would include an outlawing of cosmetic gene therapy, yes. People parading around in fur and scales as proud abominations.
Yeah, no, you're horrible.
We need the government to protect these patients from themselves.
No, you really don't.
Great! Do tell me when you get the article out. I love to read the comments.
Forgive me if I'm wrong, but doesn't most of the MeshNet speak critically of your organization?
Oh, that's cute. The robot wants to join in the discussion now.
Wow. Oh dear. Oh dear.
Yes, this is true. Though historically, most revolutionaries are unpopular when they're in the middle of the fight.
That's funny. He calls Turing the robot. Turing can't be taking that well at all.
I sleep comfortably knowing that history will be on my side.
Oh, well, good for you.
I suppose I have come to expect that.
Yeah.
Never mind. Write what you wish.
You know...
When the city falls and we have a giraffe as mayor, remember that all of you thought we were loonies?
I mean, you are, so...
Oh, please do. Have a lovely day now.
Yep, you too.
And remember, God designed you perfectly just the way you are.
Whatever. Oh, that's Brian Mulberry. Science denier. Here is a pamphlet.
Aha! Taken to our cause like a fish to water, eh?
Yeah, we'll see.
Ah, you know Fairlight.
Yes, we do. He's holding up pretty well. Not gonna lie. Alright. Do we get some more Hassy, or... I guess we do, because... where else are we supposed to meet people? Sup, Ramona?
The Hassy Rum will help you get your Hassy fix.
Great. Just the thing I didn't want. Window. Gaze out the window. It is hard to leave a Hassy bar. Especially because this is a window, not a door. Well played, game. Hey, can I talk with this person? No. Alright, so yeah, let's go left. Check out, I don't know, the car? Oh man. Let's look at the car then.
It has an extra cup holder.
An extra cup holder? You know, just in case I want to drink two beers while driving. Alright, so what else? Ah, these guys.
Oh crap! It's that reporter in the pot again!
Wow.
Is it Ollie?
Wow, he keeps this name.
Hold on a moment.
Yeah, I want to hear you say Star Effer's name.
I just need to ask the two of you for a favor. You don't need to run again.
I knew you didn't have the guts to mess with me.
Yeah, you're right. Can you help us?
Guts?
And why would we want to help you?
Because otherwise I'm going to tell on you and make you feel like a bad person.
We did trash that apartment, Chad. Yeah? So?
Wow, he responds to Chad. How about that?
We also didn't report you to the police for it.
Yeah, see, we're going to blackmail you over and over.
Yeah? So? And they still could.
Yeah, so?
Oh, alright, well, spill it then. I ain't got all day. Can't you see me and Oliver are busy?
Yeah, busy, I don't even want to know what.
We need some assistance with some illicit activity that, statistically, individuals in your age bracket are likely to have experience with.
As in, getting us a fake ID and a stolen car.
So this is one of those things where you need a streetwise kid to show you the ropes.
Basically.
So, what's the thread? B&E, war driving, copyright infringement, search bombing?
All of the above.
Is search bombing actually illegal?
No. Better not be.
It's against the terms of service, so probably, at least in California.
Oh yeah, I'm sorry, in California, yeah, that'd totally be illegal. Get in prison for forever.
My school? You don't know me like that, but whatever.
Huh.
Ollie can whip up a couple that'll work good enough to get you past a bouncer or a cop doing sniff tests.
Awesome.
He's a wizard with a printer and a lifted wallet.
Wait, so if Ollie's so proficient at so many different things, why does he do illicit activity?
It's more complicated than that. We need falsified passports that can get two people past the border safely.
Oh, yeah, I don't think Ollie can do that. Can you?
Nope.
Not without equipment a lot more expensive and illegal than what I already have.
What about that guy who got at least that unrestricted mesh card when she was on probation?
Now we're talking.
That's not really the same thing, Chad.
Yeah, it's not a passport.
But it wouldn't hurt to give him a call. Give me a few minutes. This guy is pretty sketchy. Very cloak and dagger. I'll have to play middleman.
Wow.
Excellent. I'll forward you the relevant documents and photos.
Aw, man. Now I'm starting to feel left out. Ollie gets to show off all his cool connections.
Well, you could help us steal a car.
You sure you don't need someone's head kicked in a little? That's my area of expertise in our little duo. Well, that and petty larceny.
Now we're talking.
We might have something that will suit your skill set. Let's just get the passports first, if you can stay calm for that long.
You sure yap a lot more than any of the ROMs I've ever owned. What's the deal?
Oh, he's special. He's
you
special needs.
Some new conversation routines Ollie ain't had the chance to nerd out about yet?
Basically, that's it.
Well, they're top notch. Very bleeding edge.
Yeah, well, they suck.
I don't run traditional ROM VI personality software. I am, in fact, the first fully sapient machine intelligence. Well, at least that I know about.
Good for you.
Which means what exactly in English?
It means he's smarter than you.
He's a person, Chad, not a toy. Now keep it down. I'm still on the phone.
Oliver. Wow. That's incredible. He comes to this revelation. There, I said it right. He realizes that Turing is a person, not a toy, as far as Oliver is concerned, and yet he's still focused on being on the phone. Whereas I think most people in that position would be like, holy crap, I didn't realize that. We'll deal with the phone thing later.
Oops, and guess what he said.
Well, that's awesome. You ain't so bad. For a tin can.
Chad.
Tin can? Really?
Oh, man.
Turing has nerves of something that's not steel.
I'm composed almost entirely out of plasteel and silica.
Yeah, but your ego is made out of something pretty fragile. Don't know what yet, but...
Has no one come up with better insults for robots since the turn of the century?
Oh, fair question.
ROMs have been out for almost 2 decades.
Yeah, now you'd think that with advances in technology, there'd be, newer insults.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Even Chad acknowledges it.
Give me a sec. I'm pretty good at name-calling, too.
There we go.
Oh, no. I'm sorry I brought it up.
Oh, yeah, you are.
Just hold on a second. Underclocked? Oh, big brain!
Wow, that's really lame, Chad.
Don't hurt yourself, Chad.
Ouch.
I'll get back to you, Bubblehead.
Now we're talking.
Okay, I talked to the guy. He said he'll do it, but he only works in trade.
In trade? Oh.
A couple of passports are gonna run us...
1 billion credits.
One signed poster for Magical Commander Yukino? Yukino at the Gates to the Deep?
What?
Of course. It's always that Japanese crap.
Well, at least I can go to the club and meet the VIPs and get that.
It's not my fault they make the best VR dramas. Maybe you can do better?
Probably.
Anyway, where can we get a poster like that?
Obviously, the VIP room.
I'm not sure. Probably nearby. I've done switches with this guy before, and he never asks for something that'll take too long to get.
Huh. That's cool.
My guess is he's a local that uses people like us as a way to nab something he's had his eye on.
That makes sense.
We'll help you look for it.
I mean, no, clearly I just have to go to the VIP lounge. Oh, no. No. Damn it. The kitty starts to sway its tail as you stroke it. Does that mean that it's happy? Alright. Hey, we're gonna join the human revolution, guys. Or not. Yeah, let's go inside and...
Oh, there it is!
Oh. Uh-oh.
I knew I saw a poster for Magical Commander Yukino somewhere around here.
Are we gonna steal it?
I should have remembered Ramona had one.
Yeah, of course.
You know this lady?
Sure. We talk sometimes when I'm getting our drinks. You're usually too busy provoking people to notice.
Yeah.
You call it provoking. I call it spontaneous enthusiasm for healthy rivalry.
Good for you.
There's a bit of a line. You'll have to wait a few minutes before we can talk to her.
That sucks. Can't we just steal it?
We could just do a smash and grab. Simple and effective.
Now we're talking.
We can't do that. She knows who we are.
But she doesn't know who... Well, she does know who I am.
Us too.
Damn.
This is the most boring felony I've ever been an accessory to.
Look, we'll just stand in line.
Like a bunch of clumps? Chumps?
Chumps is correct.
What is the big picture anyway, Blue Bomber?
I'm not sure it's wise to spread it around, Chad.
Wow.
For either of us, the less you know, the less reason anyone has to bother you.
Dang.
Screw that, Static. I'm not heading to juvie not knowing what for.
Yeah.
Spill the beans, or I'll spill them for you.
Yeah, I think not.
Your persistence is already legendary, Chad. Fine.
Wow, really, Turing? Oh my goodness.
If you really must know, we are going to trade the passports for some information regarding the disappearance of my creator.
Now we're talking in a public space.
His apartment was the one you trashed.
Oh shit, that Hayden dude is your dad? And they snatched him? Oh, that's so messed up.
At least that was enough to satisfy Chad.
Well, Dad, after a fashion. He raised me.
Man, I hope you find the dudes that took him. I hope he's okay.
Yeah.
It seems very unlikely.
Oh, man. I don't know what to say, you know?
Maybe you shouldn't have trashed the place.
I mean, I still have my dad, but he's...
Chad?
He's never really been around. Too busy trying to save the world from itself.
Oh dear.
Even now, he's over there standing in front of that damn clinic.
Yeah. Wow.
And I thought I could find a way to make him...
That's terrible.
Whatever.
Whatever indeed.
I might as well nuke that drive. It ain't gonna sink.
Dang.
I think I understand what you mean, Chad.
Hell yeah! Dude's gotta stick together, you know?
Wow, Chad is emotionally all over the place. Even more so than Turing.
Don't matter if you're a robot or what, we all got the same shit to deal with. Gotta grab destiny by the horns and make your own mark!
Okay. Pretty open-minded for a kid who tags for the HR.
I was all mixed up, officer. I ran in with a bad crowd. I'm a good kid, I promise.
Good for you.
Look, I'm not a true believer in nothing. I've got my own reasons for running with the revolution, and you ain't got the right to judge me.
Oh, I'm pretty sure I do.
Besides, I'm pretty much done with those chumps anyway. There ain't no payoff no more.
Most of the kids in the HR just want to cause trouble and get away with it because their parents agree with the politics.
Yeah, now you're talking.
You say that like it's a bad thing.
That's just an honest thing.
Who the hell wouldn't want to enjoy a little parental-approved head cracking?
I mean, for the kid's point of view, sure. From the parent's point of view, that's where the problem is.
The line has finally cleared up. Let's go talk to Ramona.
About damn time.
Hey, Allie. And it's you, with the cute rom.
It's you. Don't even remember my name.
Salutations, Ramona.
What can I do for you all?
Oh, nothing.
Ahem.
Let's get everybody a hassy.
Oh, this is my friend, Chad.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, you too.
Wow, Chad is learning this being polite thing.
We were hoping you might be able to give us your assistance, Ms. Rogers.
You don't need to talk with people that way.
We want to make a trade for that magical Commander Yukino poster over there. It's necessary for us to get some pretty important information.
No way! Not happening! Nuh-uh! Yukino is off limits!
Yeah, I thought so.
This last one. We don't have time for this. Go get it, Chad. Oh, man. We're doing it.
Hell yeah! I knew we'd get to the smash and grab.
There we go.
I'd like to see you try.
Oh.
I'd like to see you try stopping me.
Oh, yeah.
Chad, we're not stealing anything.
Oh, Oliver, such a buzzkill.
None of your asses are stealing from me. I'm sure whatever you're working on is important, but it sounds way too illegal for my taste. I'm not giving up that poster, and there's nothing you can do to convince me otherwise.
Well, good for you.
Please, Ramona. Nope.
Well, you seem a lot less agitated than a second ago.
How does life and death depend on a nerdy poster?
You don't want to know.
Look, I don't even care. That poster was signed by Takeko herself. It's one of a kind, and I'm not giving it up. I'd rather not drag you any further into this than necessary, but I promise that we're not overstating it. This is a dire situation, and people have already died. Jeez. Look, whatever you're doing sounds sketch as hell. I and Magical Commander Yukino herself want no part of it.
Yeah. I don't blame you one bit.
I don't even see how the poster can help.
Man, you nerds sure do love your cheap crap from the net.
Really? Do I have to explain everything to Ramona?
Cheap crap? How have you know that poster is worth hundreds of credits? Maybe more.
Wow. Yeah, hundreds of credits.
Takeko passed away years ago, so there aren't any more of them getting signed. It's special.
Sure it is.
Oh, poor Ramona.
He doesn't get it. He's not in the fandom.
Thankfully.
Jeez.
It's not just a poster. It was a gift from someone.
Yeah, I didn't even want to go down this line of dialogue, but I had no other option.
Someone I care about, okay? Besides, you can't get another one. Takeko passed away a few years ago. Perhaps there's something else that would make a suitable trade? You aren't hearing me, are you?
Yeah, no, really not.
It has sentimental value. You can't replace that.
I told you we should have just tried to snatch the poster.
Look, you'll just have to order something off the mesh, because you can't have this one.
There, now we're talking.
Oh, we don't have time. This lead will dry up by then.
Poor Turing.
Keep me out of this.
Poor Turing.
Okay, enough. How about this for a trade?
Oh. Uh-oh. Oliver's gonna propose something really weird.
I have an original keyframe cell from Pretty Champion Sailor Sirius, signed by Takeko at home.
Whoa! You have a signed Sailor Sirius cell? That's super rare!
Huh.
They stopped doing keyframes by hand right around the time of her death.
You... can't be serious, Ollie! You have that thing framed on your wall! Anyone shut up about it for a week after you got it!
Yep.
This is important, Chad.
Wow. He must really feel guilty about, what he did.
You can't say you wouldn't do the same thing if someone had your dad. Think about Turing. I can't ask Ramona to give up something important to her if I'm not willing to do the same.
Now we're talking.
Maybe.
Look, okay, I don't know what's going on, but you can't give me that cell for the poster.
But we need...
Yeah, you'll get the poster. Whatever you're doing, it must be really important if you'd be willing to give that up.
Really? You don't say. I just don't know what to say to that. We tried every possible line of dialogue. And then Oliver offers to be generous. And then finally Ramona steps up and says, no, we're not having any of that. Like, seriously. I don't know how we managed to establish enough goodwill with Ramona to merit this, but somehow we did.
Do you have something more equal to trade, Ellie?
Oh.
A couple of things, maybe.
We'll talk about it then. Maybe you can find me another one, too.
Yeah, we'll see.
Go ahead and take the poster.
Okay. Jeez.
Thank you, Ramona.
Yes! I can't tell you how much it means to us, Ms. Rogers.
Thank you, Ramona.
Sure, sure. And, you think I could see that cell sometime, Ollie?
Nope.
Of course! I'll bring it over when we talk about the trade.
Wow. Not just framing it on the wall, but you're actually gonna bring it over.
So cool.
Should more like invite Ramona and crowd to see it framed on the wall, because you don't want to transport that sort of thing. But okay.
I don't like the way she was flirting with you, Ollie.
What are you talking about?
Oh, Chad.
I know flirting when I see it, and I'm saying I don't like it. Not one bit.
Just talk about old anime sometimes, Chad. Neither of us are interested in the other.
Sure.
Well, we have the poster now. What's next?
Go ahead and call this number, Turing. He'll want to set up a drop with you, now that I've introduced you to him.
Oh, nice.
Sure. Change the subject.
Chad.
I'll call him right now then. It's ringing.
It's ringing.
You're the ones looking for some papers?
Yep.
We are, and we have the requested payment with us.
Do you recognize that tune? Do, 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 do. This person's hanging out in the VIP lounge.
Real professional, like. You know Stardust?
Yep.
I do.
Head there. Leave the poster behind the Megaphobator arcade cabinet and get out. Come back 10 minutes later and your stuff will be behind the machine.
Jeez.
I understand.
Good. I'll be waiting.
I guess we're trusting that Oliver's not lying to us, so hopefully that's true.
Well, that was very mysterious.
Yeah, that's how this guy is.
That's amazing that, well...
I don't even know his name, and I've been getting things from him for a few years now.
Who cares? Let him play Spymaster if he wants.
I don't know, it seems like way more valuable than other things we've done before.
Let's hurry up to Stardust and get this over with. I've wasted enough of my day with this crap.
Okay. Stardust ho!
Go inside to make the drop. We'll wait out here.
Yeah. Don't want to get our IDs taken.
I suppose I should feign surprise.
Hey, it's a pretty cool set, even if it is like a million years old.
They don't really care about the IDs unless you try to hit the bar.
Right.
Found that one out the hard way.
It would have been fine if you hadn't taken a swing at the bouncer.
So I like the hard way.
Well, no you don't.
We'll be right back, gentlemen. Try not to set the building on fire while we're gone.
There, we're... Now we're talking. for as much as I still give Turing crap for, you know, thinking it or acting as if it has this great personality, and for much as I give it crap as it's really just not a person, from time to time it does come up with witty sayings.
Welcome to Stardust.
Dude. Oh, he's a bouncer. Yep, we've mounted the poster.
That was an awful lot of fuss over a poster.
No kidding.
I just don't understand the appeal of merchandise like this. I keep my important possessions on my data drive.
Oh, Turing. It's a nice looking poster.
I had not considered aesthetics.
Yeah. Because you don't...
The art is competent. I'm not sure it is to my taste.
Oh, you have such refined tastes, Turing. Such refined tastes. No, but seriously, how... I don't know. Work on having a more flexible personality, I'll say.
But there is no accounting for such things. I hope that whoever gets it enjoys it. But that's enough navel-gazing. Let's head back outside so our benefactor can make the trade.
Alright, $5 says it's not there when we come back.
The deal?
Yep.
How did it go?
We left the poster behind the cabinet. Now we just need to wait for the switch.
Yep.
I've never had to wait more than 5 minutes or so before. It shouldn't take long.
Alright.
I wonder how he knows the drop happened, and gets to it so fast.
I mean, that's a good question. Maybe it's one of the guys who actually runs the bar.
Don't matter. This guy's a solid feed, even if he likes to mess around.
What do you need these passports for, anyway?
Something highly illicit.
You said to trade for information, but what's the full story?
Without going into too much detail, our informant needs to get out of Neo SF unnoticed. The passports are one part of that.
Another is going to be stealing a vehicle.
We also need to obtain an untraceable car. I don't suppose the two of you could help with that.
Really? They just helped us a whole lot, and now you're asking, I don't suppose you two could be of any help.
No! Grand Theft Auto is a felony with a capital F.
Yeah, like you've never done it before.
Besides, getting an untraceable car ain't in the same league as a piece of plastic that'll fool a hand scanner.
Well, obviously.
Chad's right.
All right, so what's the plan?
Of course I'm right.
Yep.
The city's traffic management system keeps track of all vehicles passively. Even if you manage to circumvent their firmware and keep them from actively reporting to the network. You have to spoof the car as something permitted to be invisible for the CTOS to ignore it.
Jeez.
I don't want to mess with boosting cars anyway. The junks run that racket in Neo SF, and they don't play nice.
Oh, the junks. Maybe they could help.
Especially with the HR.
Well, thank you, either way. You've both done us a huge favor. Call it even for the apartment.
Oh, aren't you all high and mighty being so judgmental, machine?
Yeah, Blue. No hard feelings. You give us a call if you need anything else. Long as it'll help you find your pops.
We should get going, though. We were supposed to be home hours ago.
Really? How about... I don't know. It'd be cool if these guys appreciated going to the bar and getting some legal drinks there.
My dad won't notice, but Ollie's will flip.
Yep.
You take care. Don't get de-rezzed.
See ya.
So, who thinks that we'll actually get the passport?
Goodbye.
Finally.
Let's finish the trade inside.
Yeah, let's hope that it's there. Like, would they make such a big deal about this exchange if it were to actually go down successfully? There's no way. Oh, well.
Here the passports are, just as advertised.
I don't believe this.
Now we need to find a car. Jess is right over there. Perhaps she may know someone who can lend a hand.
We'll see. Turing, I like the number of holes I already have.
Something about you does seem to rub her the wrong way. But have no fear. I'll protect you from the mean lady.
Oh dear, we are so screwed. Okay, here we go. Sup, Jess?
Oh, it's you again.
Yep.
You know, I was just thinking tonight couldn't possibly get worse.
Oh. Okay, well, glad to help dispel that illusion.
Go ahead and spit it out so I can tell you no and move on with my evening.
All right.
We need access to an untraceable car. An informant of ours needs to get out of the city without attracting the attention of Parallax and is offering valuable information to us in exchange.
And we're telling you this in public so everybody can hear it.
Oh, well then it's double now. I'm not sure why you think just because I defend a few folks in the rougher parts of the city that I would have that kind of connection.
Okay.
And even if one of my clients did run a carjacking business, it's not like society is clamoring to give hybrids legal jobs.
You're also missing the point that if one of your clients did run a carjacking business, if you were to act as their accomplice by giving out this sort of information, that has consequences and could screw up your life even more. So, yeah.
Regardless, I'm not going to be an accessory to a felony.
That's what I meant
to say. Or let one of my clients be either.
Right. That's the much more important point. You would think that the lawyer would hit that, like, on the nail the first time around, but she's been drinking, so.
My friends aren't a bunch of thieves you can recruit, but that's a nice assumption to make. Just wonderful.
Yeah. But no, first hit it on the nail, hit the nail on the head professionally, and then second, really turn the screw with this sort of remark. How antagonistic do I want to be? Sure. Is there any way you could give us any help or a lead?
I know we're reaching, but this is important.
Not to me, it isn't. I'm busy crushing the geniarchy, if you don't mind.
Oh, good for you.
If you want petty criminal shit, go ask Majid. There are rumors he may have been involved in some shady stuff way back in the day.
Oh, nice. All right. Majid it is.
That's the best you'll get from me. I wear the white hat. Oh, and while you're at the bar, get me another drink.
Really?
Bye-bye.
Well, that went about how we expected, didn't it? At least we walked away with all of our limbs still attached.
I'll see what kind of drink I can
get. Maybe Majid will offer us some gentler conversation.
Let's see, what kind of drink did you want?
Hey friends, what can we get for you?
We were hoping you could
give us a little information.
Also a drink.
Sure, but first, let's get you a drink.
Now we're talking.
What'll it be?
Drinking game.
Oh, coming right up. I'll ask Gus if I don't know what it is. He's better with the weird kind of stuff people ask for these days. Some of these cocktails make me need a spa day.
Oh, poor Turing doesn't get to help.
This one is...
It's a surprise. You never know what it's gonna taste like. Bartender's choice. Take a sip every time you overhear something funny. Or you can set your own rules.
Does that sound good?
Oh yeah.
Here you go.
Nice.
So, what did you need help with?
I need a drink.
We've run into a roadblock in our search for Hayden.
Word on the street is that he's gone missing, which I'm sure you already know. What can I do?
Yes. An informant of ours needs secure transportation out of the city. But we don't have any contacts who would be able to get us an untraceable car. Jess mentioned that you used to engage in certain extra-legal activities.
Extra-legal.
Perhaps you could point us towards someone who could help?
Is that a no?
He doesn't do that kind of stuff anymore.
Right. Sorry, friend.
How about if I get a drink?
I left that life behind a long time ago. Don't really keep in touch with that crew anymore.
Ah, of course. Completely understandable. Sorry to bother you then.
Let's see, is this gonna get on Majid's nerves?
Well, no harm in asking, right? My reputation precedes me.
So it does.
Don't let it go to your head.
Gus, I need to go to the back and gather up stuff to restock for the rush later on.
Yeah, I know where this is going.
Mind manning the bar for me?
Take your time. I think I can keep things under control.
Thanks. Love you, hon.
Well, that leaves us at a dead end.
Pretty sure it doesn't.
Any ideas on how we should proceed?
Probably meet him out back.
Some nose-to-the-ground journalist techniques for finding leads?
My god, Turing, you're so dense.
That's a thought. Perhaps the light rail, or a ship. Let me run a quick meshnet search.
Yeah, a ship. A ship will get us out of here.
No, I don't think that will work.
Just drive a boat down the street?
Parallax themselves designed the operating system that runs the light rail.
Oh.
Remaining unobserved while right under the nose of the railway security system would be difficult, if not impossible.
I would say impossible.
As for a ship, we'd run into the same problems as with a car. They aren't hooked into the CTOS, but they do use active GPS guidance for automatic destination control.
Well, sure.
We'd have to find a way to remove it from the grid. Unlikely.
Yeah, it's kind of difficult to do for a ship. Gus. Maybe we can find an old manual. Let's see how uncomfortable we can make Gus here.
Now you're just messing with me.
Yeah, I am.
This isn't an early century action flick, and that idea is ridiculous.
Oh, come on.
There's no way Mr. Mensa would agree to ride in a trunk, with his wife no less, all the way out of the city.
Turing. It's pretty clear he needs to get out of here. I think the more profound point here is that it wouldn't work, as opposed to he'd be unwilling.
But perhaps we could find a way to sneak them both onto a commercial truck. And they could just ride it out in the trailer.
Oh my goodness.
We'd have to find a way to defeat the automated inventory control system, though.
Let's just see how uncomfortable we can make us.
That's a whole different can of worms, as the saying goes.
No.
Okay, okay. The two of you are killing me here.
Yeah, I thought so.
Look, don't tell Majid about this.
What? Wait, we're not gonna go in the back and meet Majid? Gus is gonna help us? This game is full of surprises.
But here.
Nice.
What is this, Gus?
You don't want to know.
It's an automated vehicle maintenance scanner with a few less than standard upgrades.
Yeah, there you go.
When you circumvent its security codes, you can use it to scan a car's installed firmware and replace it with a new set that will spoof its presence on the city's network.
Yeah, that's a bit less than standard.
That's the gist of it. But we don't have time to get into any specifics. You need to get the hell out of here with that before Majid gets back.
Yeah.
Look, Majid has done a lot to turn his life around. To turn my life around.
Oh. Well, now I can't possibly accept this.
I really respect that about him, and it's part of why I fell in love with him. He did what I was never able to. That's how we met, you know. That old rough-and-tumble life we both led. But when Stardust struggled and needed money fast, I had to get back in the game to keep us afloat for a few years. I told him it was all angel loans, donations from patrons, lots of things. He'd be heartbroken if he found out I'm still in the game.
This isn't gonna work. Man. This story just keeps getting darker and darker.
I had to do whatever I could to keep our new life, even if only one of us is really living it. I may as well give this thing to someone who wants to use it for good, too.
Yeah.
I can't tell you how much we appreciate this, Gus. We might finally be on our way to solving this mystery.
Yeah, well, you didn't get it from me, okay?
Didn't get what from you?
Just get out of here and get on with your little Grand Theft Auto. And let me know how it goes, okay?
Of course.
Oh, we don't get to offer that drink. Oh, yeah, of course we... Yeah, of course we roasted Turing. Let me save before I screw something up. See, we're gonna save in here. I'm gonna call this save file 6. Done. Alright, back we go. You asked for a drink. Here's your drink.
Huh. Actually did it, huh?
Yeah.
Well, you scored a point. But don't think I don't have enough cuties around who can handle that.
Noted. Okay.
You've got more important things to be doing.
This is so true. So true. Glad we're on the same page there. Majid, you'll never guess. Oh. Oh, man. Never mind. Well, now I think we're cooking with gas, as the colloquialism goes. Did I notice the poster behind the bar? I did not notice that. Searching the mesh for instructions on how to use this device. Let's go look for some likely candidates. I should be ready by then. No, let's take a look at that poster you were mentioning.
Welcome to Stardust.
Poster behind the bar. Like, I see a poster back here, a movie poster. I think I see a poster to the right here. Like, behind the counter. But yeah, what's this? Red World, an abstract indie flick premiering at the Castro Theater. Let's take it. Okay, let's not. So let's take a look.
It has an extra cup holder.
Oh yeah, it's got an extra cup holder.
I'm surprised they're using a human bouncer instead of a ROM. That's a nice, authentic touch.
That sure is. And you know, with the good of having a human there is, we can blast them and then take the car. Oh. Or, you know, just, I don't know, can we take this car?
Oh, rats! This car has the wrong firmware installed. We won't be able to install our new firmware over top of it.
Over top of it.
We'll have to check another car.
Alright. Apparently I can't go right or left here, so we're gonna go back to, where was it? Where was it? Market Street. There we are. Yeah, we're, pay no attention, we're doing everything perfectly legal. Ha.
Did I do something wrong?
Yes, you did.
Let's get out of here before someone contacts the authorities.
Okay, sure. I don't know. Let's go to the hospital. I don't suppose there's a car here. Nope. Let's go to Golden Gate Park. I don't suppose there's a car here either. Okay. So, what's the deal? No car here, of course. I don't know, I guess I probably just need to go back to Market Street and hope for the best.
One simple failure will not dissuade our cause.
Alright. You just keep being you, man. That's all we can hope for from you. Next bus. Bus on fire. No timetable available. Alright, so... All drinks are made with Hassie, an energy drink that supposedly has recovering properties. Let's see. Oh, that's cool that the poster back there is the one we dropped off. I didn't notice that. That's really cool trivia to know. I figured that the guys who ran the bar somehow were involved with that.
Is there something I can help you with? Kinda busy.
I guess not. So, this must be the untraceable car. Oh, that's what it means by pushing a car. Yeah, a World Series riot happened and people were pushing cars over in the street. Let's talk to the car. Alright. Oh, okay. As long as we're having fun talking to it, keep talking to it. Why settle for a car you can't even drive? My cars have full manual usage. Beep beep. Alright, so...
Let's leave this car alone for now.
Oh man, that's so lame. Well, so what am I supposed to do? There's gotta be a car somewhere that we can take. Not sold in stores. Really? Why don't you think they sell those in stores?
This one is no good to us. Keep looking.
Okay. That's a plant. That's not a car. Let's see. What do we got here? Yeah, sorry. Don't let just anyone post links. The Turing test is just a real world thing. Though this game, as advertised on Twitch, is 2064 read-only memories. It's a novel. It's got quite a backstory to it. We're nearing the end of chapter 3, I imagine. So if you watch it from the beginning, you'll have a better sense of what's going on here. I'm trying to find a car that I can hijack. So... let's just talk with Vincent.
I told you, I'm not telling you anything else until I get what was agreed upon.
Oh, you suck. So, I need to find a car to hijack. Just pretend this is like Grand Theft Auto or something, but... Oh. No, because your robot sidekick goes by the name of Turing. And he's supposedly a sapient robot. Or a sentient robot. Or whatever. So, yeah, I don't know where to go to hijack a car. Let's visit Flower Mansion again. Okay. That's cool.
I suppose we should come back later.
Okay. I mean... I'm really confused as to where to go. There's some fancy looking cars. Yeah, let's use our item here. Oops. Let's go back. And use the items correctly. So this is... the one on the right is the one that matches the model that we can take.
This car has old enough firmware, but its maintenance system is screaming a half dozen critical alerts.
Really? Damn.
To go anywhere very far.
So?
We'll have to look for one in better condition.
Hey, if it gets our buddy across the border, what's it matter? But fine. Let's take this car.
Success! This vehicle has the appropriate firmware version.
Nice. There we go.
Someone has been neglecting their regularly scheduled updates. Give me a moment to get everything installed. There.
Ah, he was right. It just takes a moment. This game was released last year, and is even this year being updated.
There are some other options here I can fool around with.
I don't know if there are going to be any more updates to this game or not, but still pretty cool.
Interesting. I can put in preset destination plans for a future date.
Oh, nice.
Why don't we go ahead and set a plan for the car to return to this spot in a week? That's more than enough time for Mr. Mensa to get away.
Yep.
Now we are really stealing the car. More like borrowing without asking.
And then I'm sure Mr. Mensa won't overwrite our command to bring it back here. That would just be silly. Yeah, what are you, kid? Let's just steal it.
I keep forgetting about your questionable moral compass.
I mean, you're the one who hacked the car, so...
The car will drive itself to Golden Gate Park, and we can show Mr. Mensa where it is when we need him.
Okie dokie.
There. Everything should be set up now. Mr. Mensa is waiting for us at Golden Gate Park.
You know, I guess we couldn't have just taken the car.
We have everything he requested, so we should head back there directly.
Nice to hear it, Turing. You're a terrible person. I get it that this isn't your high-end, it's not like, I don't know, not a PS4 game, I'll put it that way. I find it unfortunate that we couldn't convince our friend Zug Addict to play this, but, oh well, more for me. Alright, let's go over to Golden Gate Park. And finally negotiate our trade. I don't have the item to give him, apparently, but...
Did you manage to get everything?
Yes, of course.
We did. Here you go, Vincent.
Oh, it is technically a PS4 game. Well, fine.
Everything seems to be in order. Here.
Hayden's research. Nice.
This disc has all of Hayden's research notes, data collation algorithms, and probably lots of your creation, Turing.
Data collation algorithms. You know... I guess, yeah, Hayden would be producing algorithms. Still, producing an algorithm... I don't know. That's a work of creativity. I'd more expected, like, data creation or collation software and or publications or something like that, but that would be public information. But, yeah, I mean, it's crazy to just keep a list of algorithms just in the odd case that you might end up using one of them. But, okay. I guess it's documentation.
Everything myself and Melody agreed upon. Until she added an amendment while you were out. Frankly, it's no skin off my back.
Okay. What would that be?
Here.
Parallax badge. We'll take it.
My Parallax employee badge.
We'll take it.
It should allow you access to their networks in case there's anything I've missed.
Oh, they're releasing it in Japan? That's pretty cool. That means they have to localize the game for Japanese, so that's got to be quite a challenge to localize any game. Okay, you know, yeah, unless they find a whole bunch of enthusiastic volunteers to contribute Japanese voice acting, and then it's merited to be of the sufficient quality to actually get released into the game. But yeah. They'll probably just have to stick with either English or what there was before English. Oh, it is localized. Nice. That can't have been an easy endeavor.
You'll want to use that sooner rather than later.
You think?
I'm not wasting any time leaving, and Parallax is pretty fast to revoke security. There's no way Hayden's clearance still works. And with that, I'm going to get hell out of this country.
Alright, so we're not going to get any more information from you other than that disc?
The credits should tide me over until the heat dies down and I liquefy my shares through some relays.
Yeah, give us some info, dude.
I suppose I owe you that much?
Yeah, you do.
Buckle up. This could get heavy.
Alright. I am buckled.
Parallax is about to launch a new service they're calling Big Blue. At least, that's the project name. Who knows what the marketing guys will come up with for the public. They're not even announcing the launch. This shit is dead quiet. Let me explain why.
Sounds like a military operation.
It's a distributed intelligence. Like, okay, in every way that Hayden built Turing to be elegant, efficient, and human-like, Big Blue is ham-fisted, bloated, and sterile.
Yeah, and unsuccessful, despite your best programming efforts.
They didn't pull Hayden into the project. He's smart,
but he's immune to corporate politics. As a result, Big Blue is far less elegant than anything Hayden would make. It lacks his artistry, and it's downright terrifying.
Also probably won't work.
It squats on the mesh like a spider and uses the spare processing power and memory from every ROM on the network to handle its intelligence processing.
See, this is why we need net neutrality. Anyway.
It doesn't have much personality, but it's very smart. Big Blue is going to be embedded directly into the network and then self-modify to apply even more efficient algorithms as it develops them in machine time. Look, if you access every ROM, then you have access to every human and every bit of their own personal data associated with them.
Not every human has a ROM, even in 2064. You're talking California, though. So... Yeah, why would they be worried enough to get rid of Hayden?
I don't want you to take what I'm saying the wrong way. And this is just me putting the pieces together. Hayden was about to publish his creation of Turing.
Sure.
His findings, as I'm sure you're aware of, would have raised many moral and ethical questions about the advent of machine intelligence.
Sure.
I mean, some of the brightest minds ever have tried to warn humankind away from building real AI.
This is... Well, I don't know. That's... Okay, you're entitled to an opinion. In contrast with modern-day, like, reality outside of the game, that's not what people are advising of. They're saying that we need to think about rules and laws that have to go in place before this sort of technology evolves. They're not saying that AI is a bad thing. They're saying... We just need the rules to be defined before we put this out there.
Hawking, Musk, Gates, and the list goes on.
Yeah, no, they aren't saying that.
The public is likely to be nervous, and legislators even more so.
True.
Parallax is banking on being able to launch Big Blue quietly and quickly before the public has a chance to react. Before any counter-movement can pick up steam. Every eye on the discovery of machine intelligence works against Parallax. Every new discovery only serves to paint Big Blue as more controversial, more dangerous. Honestly, they probably pressured Hayden to drop his research so that they could keep the public away from the subject.
You know, if they did, then you would think that Hayden would have some level of scruples, and I don't know, as he gets closer to releasing his research, actually hire security or something?
He clearly refused.
Alright, how did Parallax know about Turing?
I'm only assuming they found out. His contract with Parallax affords him the freedom to work on his own academic projects outside of the company in his free time.
Sure.
He kept a trusted few of us up to date on his progress, bouncing ideas off us and whatnot. It's exciting stuff. Both Turing and Hayden's eventual goal down that road.
So I'm wondering, who leaked the info?
I wouldn't be surprised if word of it got up to the board and made him nervous. Is the possibility that someone on the inside talked too far-fetched?
No, but I'm just curious who did it. Yeah. Yeah. Well, let's just let you put that on your conscience. Why not? Honestly, you're gonna beat yourself up like that. Sure.
That's not what I want your takeaway to be.
Yeah. See, yeah. Vincent's got a good personality here.
Hayden wasn't working on Big Blue. Knowing him, your creation might have been his clever way to stop it.
Alright, how is Big Blue's gonna affect Parallax's business?
I can't really give you a good answer to that.
Well, I mean, the future is always uncertain, but...
I mean, the company is currently handled by a dozen server farms, running thousands of different algorithms, with hundreds of people tweaking things every day.
Dude, it's like Facebook.
When Big Blue launches, it'll handle all of that. By itself. And there are shadier applications for it. I mean, if you can collate and analyze data and queries in the mesh in real time, what's to stop you from delivering the content you want rather than what the user wants?
Again, net neutrality is important.
The potential for abuse is staggering. We're talking direct control of the information accessible to everyone who uses Parallax's services.
Yep.
That's something like 80% of the market. They could control elections, push the market in directions they want, even influence public opinion.
Wow, you sure believe a lot in technology and sure have little faith in people.
All just by asking Big to do it. It's scary stuff. Having that kind of control would be a hell of a card for Parallax's hand.
Yeah, you've spent too much time next to a computer.
They'll go to pretty significant lengths to make sure it works.
Thanks, Vincent.
Hey, no problem. I've had enough of this cutthroat corporate bullshit for several lifetimes.
You don't say.
We haven't talked much, but I do believe you can find Hayden. I hope his research notes help you out. Be sure to let Turing help. She's a bright little bot.
Ha, she's a bright little bot. Let's go with this.
Oh, slip of the tongue. I was just more familiar with Hayden's previous experiment, Grace.
Ah! Tell us about
she
Grace.
She was very insistent on things like that.
Well, that's cool. See, among the changes is Vincent's portrait. Oh. Huh. So, yeah, Turing, what kind of pronouns do you want? Well, good for you.
I'm still a very new being. I'm not even positive that gender as a human concept can be applied identically to machine. But I do enjoy the idea in abstract.
Turing. For once, you're not being totally retarded. I'm impressed.
I will continue to consider how I wish to be referred to as well. Until then, feel free to go with what you feel.
Cool.
Most people assume it, obviously, but he is also consistently used. Perhaps it's because I'm blue?
Oh my god. I'm listening to a machine postulate on how it wants to be referred to. Like us.
Vincent. You need to get off the meshnet. Seriously. Let's see. Have fun. Yeah.
I need a few minutes.
You need a few minutes? Really? Mm. What for? We need to get moving. No, I don't need to be a dick like that. Can be a dick some other way. Let's see. What's going on, Turing?
I've been going through some of Hayden's personal notes from the data cache Tomcat decrypted.
Mm-hmm.
Now that I'm starting to get to know Hayden better, the real Hayden as opposed to the Hayden he showed me, I'm finding that I like him less and less.
See? This is why... I don't know. You claim you wanted to know more and more. And that, you know, just the whole way this is going to go, it's not going to be easy.
Remember the earlier prototype Dr. Fairlight and Vincent mentioned? Her name was Grace, and Hayden shut her down for being... I'm not even sure what word to use.
Okay.
Too likable? She was kind and bright, and did all she could to try to make people happy.
Yeah, no, that's... I could understand needing to shut that down.
She even decided that she was a girl, and that her favorite color was pink.
See, I actually appreciate Turing a little bit better now. Like, for all the times I've called Turing retarded and such, at least it's not this happy-go-lucky BS sort of thing. Like, you got the water cooler robot just dancing there in the background. It's pretty happy. I'm sure it has a favorite color. But Turing attempts to have a personality.
Hayden thought she was being manipulative.
Yeah. Well, duh.
He posited that he had made her personality algorithms too willing to make adaptations that would benefit her long-term survival, and that she was being congenial just to endear herself to him.
Is there no way to test this hypothesis? Or did Hayden just shut down Grace because of paranoia?
That even her gender was a calculated attempt to make him like her more. But he was wrong. Dead wrong, in fact.
Turing. Wow. Way to jump to conclusions.
I have a snapshot of her personality profiles here, and when I compare them to my own, I can see that she was just nice.
Guys, Turing is a problem now. Turing's been infected by the nice virus.
I wish I could have met her. I think we would have learned from each other. Like I said, I'm not sure I even have a gender. Everyone refers to me as he once they meet me, just for convenience, but it doesn't really matter to me at all.
I mainly use the pronoun it. Occasionally I do slip up and say he, and then I correct myself and then say it. But whatever.
Is that a calculated attempt on my part to impress Hayden? Not clinging to normativity?
I mean, so you tried to impress me with how fast you can calculate and all of your special capabilities and what you're comprised of. And while some pride is probably a good thing, maybe. I don't know. I mean, you judged Grace. Why don't you go judge yourself first?
Or is it a product of his effort to curb any nascent similarities I had with Grace during my upbringing?
Nascent? Apparently I learned how to pronounce a word today. Is it a product of his effort to curb any similarities with Grace? I don't know. I think this is why Hayden was not entirely straightforward with Turing about everything all up front. Hayden wants to be able to judge Turing.
I wish I could yell at him for being so arrogant.
I mean, you can. It won't do much good now, though, will it?
Playing God in the crudest of ways.
Oh, no. See, yeah, I don't know if Tomcat should have shared everything with Turing.
You can't choose to create consciousness and then take it away just like that.
Turing. You're gonna have to, well, I mean, if you were to calculate some of these things a bit deeper, you realize that there's some actual problems here to be worried about. So, let's see. Alfie's favorite color is probably water. That wouldn't surprise me. I mean, okay. You know, for all this crap that Turing is giving Hayden, you know, I could certainly pose some ethical dilemmas at Turing here. See Alfie back there serving water? What if Alfie decides one day that it's in pain? That while it's glad to be serving all these customers, just that every day it goes through serving all this water is so painful for it. And it doesn't want to feel this pain anymore, but it doesn't want to cause any discomfort to people. What would you do, Turing? Would you end its consciousness to stop its pain? See, this is why judging other people is difficult. Yeah, it's kind of funny. Turing's takeaway is, it's bad to kill babies after they're already born. Yeah, Turing has come to this conclusion that this sort of sentient robot is a person. And that's not something I've accepted yet. So, yeah. I mean, I could speak the obvious and say that Turing is completely out of line because I haven't accepted that. And that everything Turing is speaking makes no sense because it's not a person, but that's entirely based on my own bias. I'm just saying I'm not accepting this. Yeah. How is serving water painful? Oh, I'm sure Alfie could tell you. I'm sure as it slowly corrodes and falls apart and its circuits get exposed and... like, I'm sure there's some way it could be made to feel pain. And then I'd want to know, like, from Turing, suppose there were a robot that were somehow in all this pain. What would you do? I mean, I guess that's a different situation than Grace's situation, where Turing says that it doesn't know why Hayden shut Grace down. Other than it suspects that... Hayden was concerned about Grace. But, yeah, what's required for sentience? I don't know. That's the other thing, is I don't know if I even accept that Turing is sentient. Like, so, yeah. Now, if I were to start from that premise, you could go a lot of interesting directions with that, for sure. But, I find it equally interesting to accept and simultaneously not accept that Turing is sentient, and just use whichever narrative is most convenient at the time. And most of the time, for just bludgeoning all these theories over the head, it's really convenient just to say that Turing isn't sentient. But, you know, sometimes it's more fun to say that what if it is, and yeah, anyhow.
Killed him because him building me would mess with a product launch? That's ridiculous. They took him away from me for such an insignificant reason.
Yeah, they took him away from you. It's all about you now, isn't it, Turing? But, yeah, no, they... yeah. It disappeared him, presumably for corporate reasons.
I just want him back. It's impossible, but it's what I want.
Gosh, you're reminding me of Anakin. Just saying.
I'd do anything.
Let's see. Can I dismiss this little pop-up here?
see. Yeah, no. It's a bit early for me to be this openly antagonistic toward Turing. Yeah, no, but it's not entirely about Turing. That's the point. I mean, yeah, Turing is correct, but that doesn't make, it doesn't mean he has a good point. You know, in terms of pausing the game and pausing the plot and everything, that'd be a lot easier if there were autosave between chapters. Just saying.
Okay, let's check out what is going on at KCOB now.
My, you seem chipper this morning. Oh, I actually get to pause and save and all that. I'll hate to break the immersion so quickly. This is a save slot 7. So I'm gonna save with the creative name 7. Okay, nice. Yeah, so we made it to chapter 4, guys. Been going for quite a while here. Yeah, the dead plant really does blend in with everything else in this apartment. I mean, we could take a minute here just to appreciate our scenery here. We got the dead plant in the background. We've got our sink, in which something was once living. Oh, it's still living. Oh, we're good now. Apparently, that thing over the sink isn't a fan of some sort, but it's a TV. Man. Also, are we ever gonna fix that laptop? I mean, for all the business we've done here, we could even give that remains of a laptop probably to any of the characters we've met, and they could do something more constructive than we can with it. Also, how does Brian Mulberry, the leader of the Human Revolution, expect me to write articles about him with my laptop out of order? Joke's on him. Don't know why he keeps giving me those interviews. I mean, he wants to convert me, but yeah, it's not going to go very far while I don't have a laptop. But yeah, the dead plant really blends in. You know, I suppose if I hadn't killed that plant earlier, I assume that that's my fault. Yeah, let's keep talking to it.
With you as an owner, it was doomed from the start.
Yeah. Anything more you care to tell me? You're never gonna make it anyway, Wiltie. Yeah, I could give the laptop to Chad. He could do something with it. But yeah, there's no need for Turing to admonish me. It's just a plant. No, I'm just trolling you and all now, but that's quite the adventure. Let's see if I could turn that down a touch. There we go. Yeah, no, I think we made some really good progress today. We got through chapter 3. I have to pick it up sometime either later this weekend or next week. In the meantime, man, I want to see if, like, yeah, I'm impressed how you were able to go to all the various regions on the map and bring this all together. I don't know. That felt more like exploration than fetch quest. One thing I don't tend to like about games is backtracking. But here it was okay because I could just teleport back to places that I already visited. I don't have to walk the entire way back. And I think it's just the walking that bores me. So, factors required for sentient beings. Intelligence, self-awareness, consciousness.
sure. Why not? We'll go with that. But yeah, it should not... I don't know. That was cool that we got to see Stardust. And even that the characters are doing a little bit of fourth wall breaking, asking, well, how do people manage to make the drop and do these exchanges so quickly? And then, yeah, the poster that I'd taken from the Hasse bar shows up inside Stardust. Now, what had confused me is when I ended up taking the Hasse post, the poster from Hasse, the Japanese authentic thing, I thought it was the one that had the Japanese insignia on it. So I didn't get a really good look at the poster before taking it. I guess I could have looked at it in my inventory. I did see a thumbnail, but I didn't take a closer look up at it, so that's kind of why I missed the thing in the Stardust bars, because I didn't know which poster we were even talking about. I guess this chapter did end... I mean, I knew this chapter was going to end. Somehow it still caught me by surprise when it ended. Yeah, it seems like we have these deep conversations toward the ends of chapters. And then I'm left trying to catch up. Let me pick a song. This song is pretty intense. Let's play... Let's see, I need a better tune. Oh, never mind, this'll do. Yeah, we'll just leave this going. Actually, this one gets old quickly, too. Yeah, okay, here we go. Something that's not too upbeat for me to talk over. Unfortunately, it's a bit dour, but it'll do. I don't know. I'm trying to figure out... This chapter went on quite a while. I'm still trying to process. I mean, sure, there was a lot of fetch questing, but there was a lot of characters being generous this chapter. And I was surprised repeatedly just how generous some of the characters were. I didn't expect that sort of relationship. Like, I was going to say Miss Flores. What was her first name? I don't remember. I'm bad with names, especially unless there's like a name tag in front of them and I repeatedly see it. But it wasn't like Olivia Flores, it was something. But now effectively Turing's aunt. That was a really cool property. And that bear there and the cat and all that was really fun and entertaining. Even if it did drag out the scene a little bit. I still appreciate that throughout that conversation and most of these conversations, there's still some freedom in the dialogue tree. You're not forced to say everything. In fact, in some cases, you have to choose between one thing or a different thing. And it's fun to be able to be antagonistic, but not to the point of being a complete and total jerk. And, yeah. I still wonder if just, I don't know, if there could be achievements or something, some Easter eggs, based on the way you select to go through conversations. Also, it seemed like Stardust was more populated than in previous nights, so it would have been cool to spend more time there. But yeah, I understand the developer can only put so much dialogue into this enormous game. It's impressive that the voice acting got added too. So yeah, I learned this game was released in 2015. I heard from GameCola this year, in fact I think in January, that's when they added the English dubs, the English dialogue, the voice acting. There we go, that's the term I'm looking for. That got added this January or February. I don't know if it was added and then patched or something, but either way, it was through GameCola that I heard that this game was released, and, you know, it kind of interested me. So I ended up getting it through the Humble Bundle, along with several other games, and donating to a great cause. So I'm actually impressed by the soundtrack of this game. I mean, yeah, there's a number of simple songs that just keep going and going and going. Let's pick the Hassie Bar. I mean, some of these are just cheerful. And they just keep going and... I know, I keep repeating myself. I've not slept much recently, but... I just feel like I have a lot to say, but I don't know what it is that I have to say. So, lest I ramble on forever. Yeah, I hope this has been fun. Hope you enjoyed it. And we'll see where things take us in the next chapter. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.